What's up, Aries? It's your girl Jupiter, Pink Alchemist, here to bring you your soulmate reading for October 2018. And these readings are general. The energy is interchangeable, so it may or may not resonate. Take what does, leave the rest, or use it for fucking entertainment purposes up in this bitch. So, the first song is Loving This Club by Usher. So, what y'all sipping on? I'm sipping on some water. I don't feel that great. I am trying to get over a cold, you guys. It blows chunks. Like, oh my gosh. Like, it's hot as hell. It's summer. And I got a cold. I mean, well, I guess it's fall now. But, you know. Whatevs. Somebody want to make love in the club. Y'all nasty. Y'all might have went out to the club and somebody was looking at y'all like y'all was a hot cake with a tutu on and a hot corn dog on a stick, a fucking piece of meat on a stick. Like, oh my gosh, somebody looking at y'all like lunch and dinner and breakfast in the mornings. I have shuffled and prayed over this deck, so I'm about to split the cards. Shuffling is not popping right now. Okay. Doing it on purpose. I'm gonna close my eyes and just be me and love the club. Love in the motherfucking club. Okay, so I'm gonna turn it down. Aries, I hope y'all are doing well, blessed, highly favored, loving yourselves, being y'all's positive affirmations here, out here in life, out in these streets, doing y'all's motherfucking thing. Okay, I'm what you want, I'm what you need, baby, physically and emotionally. Be your medicine. Take every dose of me, baby. So, yeah, this is your soulmate energy reading for October. So, the first card we got is the Ace of Spades. The sights on. Pair nights on. On the floor. Yeah, you know I'm trying to go. Hey. Okay, anyways. Jeezy is mine. Yep. Okay, anyways. I have the Ace of Spades. So, Ace of Spades talks about revelation, realization, understanding, ideas, significant change, door closing for another one to open. So, we know our aces represent a newness, something new. Someone having a revelation or something. Somebody realizing some shit. Oh, excuse me, you guys. Somebody realizing some shit that they didn't realize before. They're now understanding something that they didn't understand before. With the Eight of Diamonds, it talks about a new job, a change of career, improving skills, undergoing training or teaching. Unexpected financial gains. So, let's see what the Four is talking about. Because somebody may have underestimated something and received, not like they received, but a commercial. Damn it! I don't got time for this damn commercial. No commercials. Okay. The next song is Contagious by the Isley Brothers. We took it way back. Well, I guess it's not that way back, but the group, the Isley Brothers, are a way back. It's 2 a.m. Just getting about to check my message. No one is called, but my home is in some bill collectors. Say you love and somebody wants to borrow money. I two-way her, she don't hit me back sometimes. bad, y'all. I'm listening to the song. Anyways, the fourth phase talks about recovery, a recuperation, timeout. Troubled times are almost over. Stability returning. So somebody's been in a sound like in this contagious energy. He done walked in on his bed fucking somebody else. This supposed to be my soulmate reading now. Come on, tighten up, Aries. What's going on? This is definitely for a different set of Aries. I don't know if Aries was dealing with a fuck nigga, because only fuck niggas do shit like that. Give me what you got. You contagious. Sexy lady, drive me fucking crazy. Drive me wild. You're contagious. Touch me, baby. Give me what you got. Okay, so. So, yeah, somebody is recovering from something, a timeout. They had a realization, a revelation of something that they, and I, you know, a choice that they made, a decision. That doors closing, other doors opening. A new, this person could be changing their career, changing the way they make money. They've been stagnant. Aries, this could be you that have been in a stagnant energy for a while, and now you're starting to come out of it. Or this could be the person that you're dealing with who has been in a stagnant energy. This could be your soulmate who's been in a stagnant energy, and now they're starting to come out of it. They had revelations. They realized some shit. They realized some more shit. Then they realized some more shit. Then they realize some more shit. Y'all know how long this been going on, so y'all know it's like a slow roll. Like, people in denial, they not really wanting to own up to their actions. They don't want to put no ownership to their actions that they've been doing. They've been in a timeout. They put themselves in a timeout, or Aries put their ass in a timeout. Put their ass on ice. Put their ass on motherfucking ice. They've been, now they're coming out of that disillusion. They've had that revelation. With the Three of Diamonds, it talks about someone focusing on work, teamwork, collaborations, indecisive regarding money, arguments. So this person has had problems at the workplace, problems at home, problems in a relationship. It wasn't just problems with you, Aries, or this could be Aries. It could be interchangeable energies. But they realized they might have realized that they was the fucking problem, and they've been trying to pin somebody else to be the problem the whole time. They've been trying to put that shit on somebody else this whole time, and now they have this realization, like, damn, I think that was my bad. I think that was my fault, actually. And, damn. So, with the Queen of Hearts, it talks about someone to turn to for advice, offering emotional support. We know the Queen of Hearts represents the mother of all mothers. Like, she is your fantasy woman. She's the person that everybody wants to be with. So, Aries, this could be you or the person that Aries is dealing with. But, this person basically was playing the motherfucking blame game. Playing the blame game. You might have even caught their ass fucking somebody else. Who knows? Either way, they had a third party situation going on. They had a situation going on where they had multiple people playing their game with them. But Aries, you ain't never signed up for that shit. So That could be Aries' little card. That could be the little karmic partner, the little karmic bitch that the Aries, either Aries or who Aries is dealing with, their soulmate, who had, that they were with, that was looking like, you know, give me what you got. Touch me, baby. You contagious. All that bullshit. Because we all know karmics are just there for the ride. They ain't there for no real shit. They ain't trying to stand the rain for real. This next song is So Gone by Monica. She says, silly of me, devoted so much time to find you faithful. I lost my fucking mind. Driving past a nigga's house and doing all that shit? Nah, Aries, if y'all doing that shit, y'all are the queen. Y'all are the queen. Being y'all's queen. What do queens do? They rule. This is not what queens do. They don't deal with fuckery. They don't deal with fuck shit. They don't. If a motherfucker is sitting up feeling like they want to touch me, baby, give me, you so contagious, and you hear the whispers. You hear people talking about what it is that they've been up to. Truly, you got your intuition telling you what it is that they've been up to. You don't need nobody to tell you shit. You ain't gotta ask yourself what you doing wrong, what it was that you did. This person is the fuck up, and they finally had a realization to realize, like, damn, they may have been thinking, you know how motherfucker try to play themselves, like, oh well, the reason why I ain't fucking with Aries no more is because she was always talking to me about bettering myself and loving myself more, and she was just too good for, she was just too good to be true. How could a motherfucker stop talking to you because you too good to be true? Or not stop talking to you, but just decide over somebody else, or just have somebody else mixed in the picture, period. They are now realizing that you were their dream girl. Not only just their dream girl, but you a lot of motherfuckers' dream girl. Shit, you have the qualities to be a dream woman, a fantasy woman to all men. Like, who wouldn't want you? Who wouldn't want a female, a queen like you? Someone who carries themselves like a queen. Someone who talks like a queen. You ain't just wearing queen clothes. You a fucking queen at night when you go to wrap your hair up, bitch. When you go to put on your little ugly ass pajamas or whatever. You having an off day. You sick. Whatever. You still a queen no matter what. This person went to a deep thought and just, I mean, like thought about the shit. Realized some shit. Woke up. Like, damn. I think maybe I fucked up. I think maybe it was me. They just finally realized that it could have just been them this whole time that kind of had shit fucked up. Either way, their fantasy girl is so gone. Aries, you are so gone. To be the last song. So gone. I don't really need you. Aries! Aries, Aries, Aries! Let this person be in their feelings. Let them be in their feelings. Let them live their life. I don't know. You continue to live yours, though. Don't even focus on this shit. You clearly, if you weren't focused on your shit, if you weren't the queen of hearts, that fantasy woman, doing your business, handling your business, giving love to others, giving love to yourself, giving love where it's supposed to be given, though. This love is no longer misplaced to a fuck nigga. This love is being placed where it's supposed to be, which is you. And if you wasn't doing that, this person wouldn't be feeling the way they do. It's all a chain reaction. They wouldn't have woke up and finally had that realization. Now, will they come to you and give ownership to their mistakes? Most likely not. I mean, I don't know. Don't hold your breath. Fuck it. Fuck them. Fuck it. Move on. You've clearly already doing that. Somebody, not even somebody, everybody sees the queen. Everybody sees a queen when she walk by. When the queen walks in the room, everybody know a queen don't walk in the room. You have your crown on. You have your crown on, no matter what. This is a state of mind. This is a state of being a queen. You are being your positive affirmations, and I'm proud of y'all. Try to share that shit with other people. Best y'all can. Spread that shit because it's beautiful. So sad, it's too bad for them. You know, they fucked up. It is what it is. Soulmate or not, you, a queen, waits for no one. A queen bows down to fucking no one. No one. And I do mean no one. So continue to be y'all the queen that y'all are. Love yourselves. I love y'all. Shoot, I love y'all. So y'all have a blessed day. Good day. Love yourself. Positive being your positive affirmations. Continue to do that. Because y'all know when these planets move and they shift and they get jiggy with it, shit be switching up and changing. But keep y'all's crown on. Keep that shit on. Y'all see that? Keep that crown on, baby. Keep that shit on. Love yourself. I love y'all. Aries, Jupiter out.